Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. This is Rahul and today we are reviewing this, the Maruti Suzuki Baleno RS right here. So we've also hit 2000 subscribers in our channel, so I wanted to thank each and every one of you before going to the video, and also comment down below what car do you want to see next and I'll do that. So just like any other video, we'll start from the front and we'll make our way through the back. Now this is the key of the car, as you can see. Now it's a very simple key and you have the lock unlock functions. I think that's about it. And this one is just a dummy piece over here on the bottom. The key is very sleek indeed and it's finished in black and this chrome kind of material, but apart from that it's very simple, as I said. So just like any other video, we'll start from the front. Now these are the DRLs that are on right now, and inside you get bi-xenon projector setup lights. So they are white in color, so the high beams are also white. And this part right here is the indicator, and down below you get the fog lamps, which happens to be just a bulb. And the car looks really smart indeed, and the one that differentiates from this, from the regular, you know, Baleno, is that the front splitter right here is a little different. And this one is finished in a little grey color, grey or silver kind of finish. And then you also get this beautiful chrome strip. And chrome has been used very minimalistically in this car, it's not too on your face, as I said. The color that we have today is a dark blue, because usually, you know, you see Balenos in red, the RS especially, but this one happens to be a different color and looks really nice. And I'll move to the alloys. Now these alloys happens to be 195/55 R16s. They are finished in black, and the regular car you get silver. But I personally feel that they could have been a little bit more bigger and could have had a different design, just because it's a RS, you know, car. But apart from that, the tire profile is really small indeed, so it has that really sporty appeal as well. Down there on the side you get the side skirts, which are also a part of the RS package, so that is that again has that silver effect. The car has some more beautiful lines across it. It is very minimalistically done, I have to say, because you have one line here and one line near the wheel arch, and then if you go around the side here as well, you get a few more lines, which looks very good indeed. The side, they are not, you know, anything different. They are just finished in regular body color. And since the car has tint, it looks really nice. It has that sporty appeal. It has that blue and black combination. And minimalistically in this car, there isn't much chrome in the car. Even the window panels or the side door, you know, panels, they are finished. The top half is finished in black, but the bottom is finished in chrome. Even the door handles are finished in chrome. You also get request sensor here, which is very nice. And I'll move to the rear of the car so you can see it a little bit more better. And the rear wheel size is the same, because this is a front wheel drive car, 195/55 R16s. And you can see that the suspension has been, you know, given quite a raise, because this is the Indian version, of course. So you can see the, you know, the space between the wheel arch and the wheel gap. It's a quite, you know, considerably a lot. And even in the rear, the diffuser is also very nice looking. So you get towing hook down there, and this one happens to be the silver finish, and you get the parking sensors in the back, and there's the RS badge over there as well. So the parking camera is down here, so it is very well integrated in this chrome strip. So this part of the, you know, piece is also chrome, which is very nice indeed. And as you can see, the car is very well, you know, kind of designed in the back, I feel, because you get LED tail lights. So if I switch this on, this part here is LEDs, and the top gets this small spoiler over here, which is very nice indeed. And I'll put the dimensions of the car in the text so you can check that out. I'll quickly show you the boot space. So I have to unlock the car, just give me a minute. Open the car, unlock it. So this is the boot space. So as you can see, the boot is actually a little bit heavy, even though it's really small, but it is quite heavy. And the parcel shelf also is present in this car. And the boarding lip is humongous. I've never seen a, you know, boarding lip this high. And you're going to need quite a lot of manual power in order to put things in and out of this car. You also get reflectors down here, which is present. And while closing, you just have to use your hand, and it's kind of big as well. So I'll show you the interior of the car now. So the interior is simply carried over from the last car, and you get the same features as the regular top end Baleno. And the steering wheel has this, you know, three spoke design. You get some more voice, you know, command and the volume buttons on the steering wheel as well. The engine start stop button is present here in this car, and the parking camera, I mean the parking sensors, I mean, and the headlight leveler. Down here you get the, you know, clutch, and you also get a dead pedal down there, which is very nice. Door pockets aren't large enough, but you can fit 1 liter bottles here. And these are the window controls which are present here. And the seats are finished in black. The general interior is finished in black, so it kind of has that, you know, mysterious look inside. The seats offer great support and kind of feedback. They are really soft as well. Now, the center part here gets a small armrest and some more space down there. It's very small. I don't think you can fit in your phone even in there. So, the handbrake is present here. The main storage space for this car here is in this area. Right now, I fit my pouch there so you can see how much of a, you know, bigger space that is, because my pouch is pretty huge. I'll just show it to you in a second. So this is the size of my pouch, and that is the size there. So even with that pouch being fit, there's some more storage space down there, so you can fit in your phone, purse and everything like that. The door pockets, as I said, is not too huge. Now this is the center console. This screen is very, you know, kind of, how do I put it, it is a little bit on the resolution is on the lower side because it takes some time to react as well, and you get voice command indeed. So you gotta use this to kind of switch this off, and home button here, and okay. So the, you know, chrome bits here are really nice. So this part here is silver, and I don't like this part where the AC climate control systems are, because I feel like this is pretty basic and could have been a little bit more better designed. In the center you get the display where your temperature is kind of shown, and the cabin space is also quite well indeed. So I am over 6 foot and in the back. So this is the back seat. I'll quickly sit and show you how the space is. So I'm inside now, and you can see the amount of space on offer. You also get scooped out seat back, so the magazine holder. The door pockets in the back are, you know, pretty large enough, so you can fit in larger bottles back here. And the headroom is also quite nice, so you know, it is pretty huge back here, and the view from the back is also pretty good. The seats back here is also nice. You get the same design. You do not get 3 headrests, only 2 in the back. So that is it for the interior and exterior of the car. Now we'll go for a drive, and I'll tell you the driving dynamics of the car. So for starters, this engine happens to be the 1 liter turbocharged petrol engine, so it happens to be the 3-cylinder engine. Now this one comes only with a manual gearbox. They don't have an automatic gearbox for the Baleno RS. So keeping in mind that this car has been detuned when you compare it to its, you know, like the abroad version. So it's on the lower power output here in India. So with that being said, we're gonna see how it performs and everything. So I'll tell you the power output now. So it happens to be 102 bhp with 115 newton meters of torque. Now that might not seem a lot for a turbo petrol engine, because you know Hyundai offers a much more powerful turbo petrol engine, even you know Kia does. So there's a lot of most, you know, more powerful turbo engines out there, but this one is still pretty decent considering the size of this car, because it's not too huge. You'd have seen the dimensions. So I'll quickly talk about the dash and everything. Now I really love this part of the dash. So it has that blue accents to the RPM meter as well as the speedometer, so it gives that sporty look. And the central screen here is also really big indeed, so it has a lot of information as well. It's quite, you know, easy to use, so you won't have much of a problem with it. So if you learn it, and you know, if you spend some time with the car, you'll be able to kind of play with really easy. Now this part here is the part that I don't like, because I feel like this is pretty basic, could have been a little bit better designed. And down here there's no complaints for storage space, because it's ampler amount of storage space down here, and you also get charging sockets down here as well with a 12 volt you know, charging sockets. And apart from that, you get USB ports and all that stuff. Talking about the steering wheel, it is a little bit heavier when you compare it to other manufacturers, and it is also a little bit heavier than the Swift that I just recently drove. And the design is very basic. It's a 3-spoke unit, so it's like almost 3-spoke. It's quite chunky as well, and you get some more you know, functions on the steering wheel, and you get the, you know, voice command and call functions and all that stuff as well. I really like it. It is quite, you know, reactive. It is, you know, they have obviously stiffened it because it's the RS and they want it to perform quite well. So that's the reason why it's a little bit stiff when you compare it to the normal model. So as you go higher, you know speeds, as you carry over speeds, it reacts really well. Now the brakes of the car is a little bit soft, you know, in the initial phase, and then as you go into it, it's very, you know, reactive. And talking about the power unit, it kind of kicks in after 2000 RPM, and as you can see, I've buried my foot down. 2000 RPM takes some time, and I was in fourth gear, just to remind you. Kind of picks up after 2000, so 2000-2500, that's where the meat of the power band lies, and then the punch is solid, so it doesn't feel like a, you know, 102 PS of BHP engine. It feels like more, so it is really good indeed. And you would have been guessing that the car might look a little dark inside. That's because the car has black interior, and apart from that, it has tints, so you know, that's the reason why it might look a little claustrophobic in here. But other than that, it is very spacious. The cabin is actually very spacious when you compare it to Swift and other cars. The rear seat space is also quite nice, so believe it or not, this car actually has a lot more rear seat space when you compare it to the entry level cars like your Hyundai Aura and stuff like that. So that is really nice indeed. The seats also offer really great support and feedback. You can also adjust the seat for height as well, so that is really nice. And talking about the gearbox, it is really smooth and fluid to use, and the clutch is also very light, so you can kind of make hard shift and fast shift. So if you're going to drive it a little bit aggressive, the car is going to support you. It won't let you down in any way. The horn could have been a little bit better, but it's decent for the, you know, look and the size of this car. It's not too bad. And of course, you can change that up if you don't like it. You can switch into something like a premium horn or something. So guys, right now we're going to launch the car, and I'll tell you how the performance is, so you can record the 0 to 100 timings and everything. So we'll wait for the road to clear out and we'll do it. Goes all the way up to 6000 RPM because this is a petrol, and it is very nice indeed. So talking about quick overtakes, you really don't have to think twice. All you have to do is downshift a gear and then give it some, because this car will give that pull instantaneously, and you know, you can have that peace of mind that you're driving a pretty powerful car and you can make overtakes easy, let it be in the city or even in the highway. So that is pretty reassuring as well. And talking about the mileage of this car, I asked the owner and he said that the mileage is somewhere around 18 kilometers per liter in the city if you're driving it, you know, very gently. And the price of this car happens to be 10.5 lakhs back when he bought it. This happens to be the pre-facelift version, as I said. Now, of course, the prices have been increased, you know, over time. So, you know, that's not bad. 10.5 for this car is not bad because it's pretty feature loaded as well. So again, if you need a downshift, do it, and then the car will pull immediately. We were just in some 4000 RPM and the car just pulls and pulls and pulls, as you can see, and the brakes are there to offer you good assurance as well. So it's a really nice package indeed, and even the high speed stability, as you can see, is very pinpoint and accurate. Not much of a body roll inside the car, and the car is very stable indeed. So talking about the ride or the suspension of this car, for the most part, it is really comfortable. So right now we are on the highways. The road is very well laid out. So it's, you know, it's tar road. So it kind of is very smooth indeed. And the suspension has also been stiffened up when you compare it to normal cars and the cars abroad to give it a little bit more sportier, you know, drive. And that is, you know, that doesn't mean that it has made the car uncomfortable, because it kind of still floats around and it is very engaging to drive as well. So I feel like it has the, you know, perfect blend of both. So it will support you when you're driving it really comfortably, and it will support you when you're driving fast as well. Now the car's weight is just under 1 ton, so I think it's somewhere around 900 kgs or something. So it's a pretty light car indeed. So that means that you can corner the car really nice as well. So since it's really light, you won't feel that weight kind of around the corner. Even if you're trying to do a tight corner, the car won't nosedive or it won't have much of a body roll, even though most Baleno owners won't be doing that. I'm just saying it for your reference. And as you can see, even the lightest of inputs will give you really good feedback as well. The steering is very pinpoint and very reactive indeed. It might not be as reactive as your Honda steering wheels, but it's still very good and very engaging to drive as well. And I'll quickly show you in-gear acceleration, out-gear accelerations and everything. So right now we are in fourth gear. I told you that the car picks up after 2000 RPM. So I buried my foot down and the punch is initially there. And then the pull is very solid. So there's no flat spots or anything. It is very smooth, very linear and really nice to drive. I feel like this car has that, you know, has that blend of comfort as well as sportiness when you drive, so it's really nice. So as you can see, since the car is really light, kind of picks up really well and it just kind of keeps going and going and going. So the high speed stability is also pretty nice. There isn't much of a body roll or you know, wobbliness inside the cabin. It kind of, you know, stays planted and pinpoint. And even the brakes, they offer, as I said, a really good you know, support for you when you're driving really fast. And even if I wanted to start the car from second gear, it's really smooth. Even if you are trying to give that accelerator so much, the car is really refined as well. So talking about the refinement, you won't hear much of the petrol engine inside the cabin because it is rather quiet. You just hear that clutter inside, but that is kind of after 3000 RPM, as you can see, then you kind of hear the clutter. But initially when you're in gear and you're kind of, you know, cruising along, you won't really hear the sound much. So that is a really nice factor there. And I have to say that this car has a really good punchy performance over the regular Baleno. It might not be as, you know, drastically, you know, different like how your Polos are, you know, like the Polo GT from the GTI or the Skoda VRS from the regular Skoda. Those cars are like on another level, but for a regular family, you know, hot hatch, this is more than enough, and they have done the differentiation so well indeed. So it is a rather nice buy here. So if you're gonna look at this kind of, you know, let's say this kind of segment of cars, I would really ask you to kind of take a look at this car too, because it's really good as a package. It has a really good, you know, amount of driving performance on offer as well as your features. So it is really nice indeed. And after that, you also have the reliability of your Maruti Suzuki brand, and the service is also quite cheap for these cars, so you can have that peace of mind over there. As for the negatives, I feel like they could have differentiated the RS a little bit more in terms of exterior, because I feel like they both kind of look the same. And you know, here and there a little bit touches like your wheels, they could have been different, and little bit more, you know, a little bit more, how do I put it, a little bit more flair, I would say, then, you know, the differentiation would have been there and it would have been really nice. So that is the only thing for me in this car, but apart from that, it is very nice indeed. Let it be the space, let it be the driving performance, comfort, everything is there. And I'm gonna downshift now aggressively. Pull is just incredible. So even after 100, the car is really, really stable. There is no feel of a, you know, wobbliness inside the cabin. It will give you that surety very well. So when you're trying to go higher speeds, when you're trying to cruise on a highway, you're not going to feel that sense of fear inside you, because the car will support you very well, and that is really nice as well. So yeah, that is it for this vlog. So if you like this vlog, please hit that subscribe button. Also make sure to follow me on Instagram and comment down below what car do you want to see next. The Tamil video for this car is also going to come really soon. And special thanks for hitting 2k subscribers. I thank each and every one of you for subscribing to the channel, and I'll see you on the next one.